The SKS rifle, it's been around for over 60 years, and it's been a very popular semi-automatic rifle here in the U.S. But if your SKS rifle was imported since 1990, and you've done any modifications to that rifle, you could be liable under federal law and breaking the 922R compliance. So we're going to talk today about how to make sure that your SKS semi-automatic rifle is 922 compliant. Now, 922 compliance stems from the old assault weapons ban. And what happened was the federal government began to regulate all guns that were being imported into the United States first before they could actually pass the assault weapons ban. And so any gun that would come in during that time was under a strict regimen of things that it could and couldn't have. Now, this old Russian SKS is a semi-automatic rifle, and for it to enter into the United States since 1990, it has to fall under strict guidelines. The AK-47, the FN-FAL, and the SETMI, and then, of course, any Segas, the shotguns, anything that's semi-automatic can only be brought into the U.S. if it is in a sporting configuration. But today we're going to look strictly at the SKS and how to make this gun compliant. What it is, there's a magic number 10. And with that magic number, you can only have 10 foreign parts regulated with this list, and then everything else has to be U.S. made. Then it can be considered a U.S. made firearm. Now, I've seen very few videos on the 922R compliance. So, and the reason is because it is very complicated. This video that I'm showing you does not replace your own homework to make sure that you are compliant, but this is going to be a guide to help you. Now, I'm going to be using a Tapco compliance kit to make this gun not only compliant, but it will also bring this rifle up into the 21st century. And go to Tapco. They have a great description with a list of all the parts that are regulated, and it's just a great source to find out if your rifle is compliant. Now, one thing I'm going to ask you to do, which I normally don't ask this, but you need to send the video out to as many people that you know that have SKSs or are contemplating buying an SKS to make sure that they are not breaking the law unknowingly. To be honest with you, it's really a bunch of bureaucratic BS. But, you know, you still are liable under federal regulation, and you want to make sure that you are compliant. Here's a list of the 20 parts that are regulated. I got this off of the Tapco website, and it does list the different parts. Now, I have this marked for the parts that apply to the SKS rifle. You need to remember that you've got to have it only 10 of these parts. That's what you really need to understand, is having 10 of these parts only for foreign-made parts. Then everything else can be U.S.-made, and then that will make it compliant. You really, for the SKS, there are only 17 total restricted parts. So that gives you, you only need 7 U.S.-made parts off of this list on your rifle to make it compliant. And what is not included on this list are barrel extensions, unless you have a Yugo. And if you have a Yugo, I'm going to show you this compliance kit does have a muzzle brake with it. Then also that fits the Yugo. Also, there are no mounting blocks on the SKS. And even though there is an operating rod, which is included in the SKS kit, the compliant kit, the BATF does not recognize an operating rod on the SKS. But if you're like me, it's just great to have that extra insurance. I will have this list posted in the description and for you to take a look at, and I'll also have the link to the 922R compliance explanation from Tapco. It really gives a great summary, and it really helps you to understand. Again, this is not legal counsel, and you need to do your own homework as well. This is a guide to help you. Now, here is the compliance kit. This is what you get when you order, and I'm telling you, it just makes a lot of sense. There are other companies that are making parts out there, but Tapco has really done this right. For one thing, they make excellent quality products, and I've used Tapco. In fact, I have many reviews on Tapco on my site. But this is the compliance kit. You only need 7 parts. The buttstock is one part, the pistol grip is a part, and then it says the forearm or the foregrip. So this is a part. So there's 1, 2, 3. Just putting a stock on your gun takes care of 3 of those parts. The magazine, and this is a 20 rounder, which makes it really nice. The floor plate, the follower, and the body make 3 parts. The gas rod here, and this is a U.S. made, and all of Tapco's products have U.S. made on the product just in case there's any kind of problem. Now, they did include the SKS operating rod in this kit, even though it's not necessarily regulated, and it is marked U.S. So this is, again, just a little added insurance. You do get the muzzle brake as well, and this is for the Yugo, or if you happen to have an SKS that has a threaded barrel, and which I do not. Mine is the basic SKS configuration. Now, on this rifle, there are a lot of parts that do not fall under the compliance. This receiver cover, the bayonet, the sights as well, small screws, your safety, your sling, all of these things are outside of the compliance, and they're not regulated, but because it's the parts that are under the list of 20 that count toward the compliance. Now, I'm mainly going to hit the highlights when I'm assembling this onto the rifle. I will be doing a separate dedicated video on how to put the stock on the SKS, and it's really not a big deal. The most difficult part you're going to have is replacing this wood part on the gas tube, and I will give you some ideas about that as well. I'm going to review the 922 compliant parts, and the first one is, we'll just consider this stock to be one part, pistol grip makes 2, and then either this handguard, I guess since this is in 2 pieces, it's either one. There are 3 parts that are included, and there are actually 4 pieces, but that's our 3 parts. The magazine is 3 parts, with the body, the follower, and the floor plate. And then we have the gas piston rod, which makes it 7. And then, of course, we still have an operating rod in here that's U.S. made as well. And then on this one, of course, I've added this gas tube that's U.S. made, but I don't think that falls under the compliance. So that gives us the 7 parts we need to make this gun legal in this configuration. And as you can see, it is a very cool design. Again, I will have an assembly video on this coming up just right after I upload this one.
I would highly recommend that you go to the Tapco website to look at their 922 compliance information. It'll really help you in making your decision. You need to be brushed up on why you're doing what you're doing. Again, thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more fun gun reviews and sensible survival. God bless America. Long live the Republic.
It don't fit. All right, we'll see about that.